How's that burly?
Ho! Oh,
there's a snapper right here.
I can't believe this, it's right here. And
oh, I want to catch it!
Oh, mate, he's going to eat my bait. He's on my bait. He's got my bait. He's got my bait.
The episode that you're about to watch, along with many hundreds more full episodes and videos to come, filmed all around the world with all different kinds of species, are all going to be available for you to watch right here for free, thanks to our mates at ITM. So, enjoy.
This incredible fishing expedition in the far north started on the west coast in a spot I'd never fished before. Some burly brought about some good snapper action before jigging brought about some frenetic kingfish action. A nice puka was a surprise catch, and a live kahawai and a handline combined to catch an even bigger kingy. Then we headed over to the east coast for some land-based fishing. I managed to pull a reasonable snapper out of the kelp, but I saw several more lurking around when I went in for a swim. So I hatched a plan and set out some overnight burly.
We'll be here at first light, and hopefully the snapper will be here, ready and waiting. Looks even better in the daylight. Hardly been able to sleep all night thinking about what might be around our burly. And now I'm about to find out. Well, that burly we put out last night has been completely annihilated. Maybe a shark has paid a visit in the night. If not a shark, a whole lot of hungry snapper. And I'm hoping it was the latter. Now, starting out the day, I've gone for a pilcher, just a single hook. You're less likely to get a snag. And the good thing with the pilchard, aside from the fact that snapper like them, is that because they're soft, even if the small fish come and start picking at them, it's going to start that feeding going, get some feeding activity going, and eventually that activity might bring in that big snapper that we want. We only want one, just that big donkey off the rocks. Justin's had a little knock from something. Maybe the burly worked last night then, eh?
There's heaps of bait fish swimming around down there. They're all little kahawais, eh? So we should have some fresh bait soon enough. Oh, some nice little kahawai too. You just wonder, the mind boggles at what's been happening here all night. There is just so much rocky coastline like this on the northeast coast that you could live an entire lifetime and not walk into all of the places on the coast. I wish, oh, hello. A little knock. Pick it up, go baby. Can back the tension off my bait runner just so he can pick it up a bit easier. Here he goes, take it. Oh no. Feel those smaller fish in there really smashing into those pillies. I'll go for a bigger bait soon. Slow the smaller fish down now that there's obviously some fish there and that they're starting to feed. Ooh. Oh, hello, 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 hello. Come up tight.
Yep.
Yeah, boy. Yeah, boy! Oh, yeah! Oh! Oh, okay, just keep them moving, keep the fish moving. The key off the rocks is to keep the fish moving. That's a snapper, and that's going to be looking for ground. There's not a lot Justin can do to stop him, though. Yeah, you've got to move, even though he's running, that's not bad, though, mate.
But those baits aren't even getting down.
Oh, hello, hello, I've been picked up.
Oh, yeah, I got fish.
Okay, I'm gonna have to leave my fish. Bugger. Are you gonna be able to get him, Just?
Yeah, mate, yeah, he's not a big one.
Well, that's not bad, because I want to eat one of those puppies.
Cheers.
There you go, now you saw what a workout that was. I don't know whether it's just because there's so much ground, so much cover here, and you're so anxious about them running into the ground that they seem tougher. or whether these local Northland boys are just tougher. I think it's just that Northlanders are tougher. Particularly versus a Jaffa.
Oh, yeah, I wondered how long that was gonna take to come out.
Hello. Ooh. That got picked up.
Yeah.
It's just swimming around sideways, might be a kahawai. It
Took it with some purpose though.
Sure did.
Oh, look at that.
First snap for the day.
Yeah, we smashed it up on the surface too. See how much less fuss that one was? Now, when you're walking in to these areas, there's only so much you can carry now. With all the weight that we're lugging in, I'd prefer that weight to be mostly in burley, because of course it's the burley that we need to attract the fish. So we don't bring a lot of bait, but what the burley does is it brings in a whole lot of bait fish. And like the rocks, like off anywhere, the best bait you're going to get is fresh bait and bait that's locally available. So I've just put on a tiny wee bait like that. I'm just going to drop that there down in front of the burley bag where the bait fish are swimming around, like so, and we'll catch some fresh bait. You can take the flanks off of that and it'll make amazing fillet baits. Or of course, we keep them in a rock pool. Not only does it keep them fresh, kingfish turns up, we've got a live bait. If we decide not to use them, we can always let them go. Now, I've just seen a nice sized snapper right here, right here, inches away from the rocks and the burley. The trouble is getting a bait through all those kahawai there. So I've got a fillet of one of the kahawai that I've caught out of the burley trail. If I can time it right, I might better just lower that right in front of his nose and see what he thinks of it. I might just lob it just off the edge there. Just let it float down, and he might just be lurking a little bit further away in the shadows. If the kahawai don't eat it, get out of it, you mongrels. Get out of it. Get out, yahoo. Now what I'm hoping is the snapper's just going to smack those little kahawais out of the road and say, oh, that's mine. Where's the snapper gone? Oh, there he is. I just see him, he's right under the sledge, right under our feet. See that little gap down there? Yep. I just saw him pop right through the gap, the cheeky hewer. Oh, hello, something's picked up this bait. Hello, yep, something's picked up the bait. Let it go, the bugger. Now, got him. Yes. Oh, I love it when that plan comes together. Sight fishing for snapper. You can see, look at the colour of that fella. He's a local boy. He was sitting right here under our feet. I needed that big slab of kahawai just so those kahawai wouldn't take it. And I just let it sink below them. As soon as, the fish have been pretty coy this morning. I'll steer him over just though. Look at that. Woo. Fresh slab of kahawai. You've just seen the system in full effect. Bring in a minimal amount of bait, use the burley to attract them, catch a fresh bait, I drop this bait exactly where I drop that little chunk to catch my bait. Predator and prey, the whole food chain is happening right there, and that's because we packed in that burley. See, he's guzzled that piece of kahawai. He's guzzled it.
Oh yeah, mate.
He's coming home.
Sure is.
How's that burley? Oh, there's a snapper right here. Where's Dave? I can't believe this, it's right here and Dave's up the hill. Oh, I want to catch it! I hope you're enjoying this classic episode, but if you'd like to see our latest content, action, tips and how-to videos, you can get it all on the Ultimate Fishing app, available now at the App Store, Google Play, or by visiting ultimatefishing.tv.
Oh, it's nice and slow too. Nah, there we go.
Justin thought he was snagged, pulled the snag off, and he expertly caught a moray eel.
Oh, nothing to do with that thing.
Ooh, sea serpent. Now you do want to be careful of the teeth on those buggers too, because they're very small needle-like teeth and they're very sharp. Now you got to watch, because these things are notorious for rolling back up on themselves and tying themselves in knots.
Oh, he's staring at me, eh?
Oh.
Yuck, you horrible monster.
Ah. Fish trying to eat a bit of banana skin. Seriously, dude.
I believe you.
The latest in chum, watch this. Here it comes. Oh, yeah. Oi! Did you get that one? Broke the surface. They're smashing them. Oh. See one. Oh yeah. Watch it. Yeah. Woo! He ate it. Oh, mate, are these bloody monkey kahawai? Yeah, the old lucky bananas, eh?
I've actually caught marlin. The banana skin. So much for bad luck, eh?
It's a good looking bait.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
How's that burly?
Ho! Oh! There's a snapper right here. Where's Dave? Come have a look. Look right there.
Oh yeah, it's big snaps.
Dave! Oh, I can't believe this. It's right here and Dave's up the hill. Oh, I want to catch it!
There he is again. Look at him right there. Ah! Oh, I think there's 6 kilo.
He looks about that size.
He's right on that burley. You can see he's just, mate, that burley's got him racked up. Right, oh, he's right on the burley pot. Look at that! That is awesome. Look at it.
Oh man, okay.
Where's Dave?
He's right here.
Where have you been, mate? There's a big snapper right here. I don't know what's going on, but as soon as our cameraman Dave goes for a bit of a wander up the hill, we see this big snapper, and of course, we didn't want to catch it without you guys being here. And now that you're here, we can maybe try and catch him. There he is, just over there. A few chunks of backbone in there. Get a bit of feeding going on. Then I'm going to try and catch that snapper that's been like my little pet for the last 20 minutes.
While there he is.
You guys wait. There he is.
There he is.
Yep. Oh yeah, there he is. There he is. There he is. Ooh. See, just all that activity. You can see those carboy. You can see the snapper there. Ooh. Got a little bit spooked then. There he is. There he is. There he is. He's a big boy. Come on, there it is. There's your bait, little bud. Oh mate, he's gonna eat my bait. He's on my bait. He's got my bait. He's got my bait. He's swimming off with my bait. I'm letting him go. Is he eating it? What's going on? We saw him take it. Oh my gosh. He's got it. Oh, that's tangled. What's going on here? Oh, he's right under the rock. He's right here. Look at him. Look at him. He's taking off. I can see him going up the gap. Right there, look! Hooking him up and seeing him instantly on the surface like that. Oh man, that is awesome sight fishing for snapper. I mean, that little guy, well, you guys were up the hill, was swimming around, I've just been fattening him up. Oh man, that's awesome. Oh, and because of course I've hooked him right here, he's green as. Man, I practically, from the moment I hooked this fish, well, from 20 minutes before hooking this fish, right through the whole fight, I've been able to see him the whole time. Awesome. Just into the net, mate. Whoa! Hey! Yeah!
Hey! Oh, he's
that's a thumper. That's a thumper, boy. It's a solid one. Yes! Sight fishing for snapper. Oh, you want to be anywhere else? I don't think so. All right, we won't muck around. Do you want to hold that rod just though? I don't want to muck around with this fella too long because I want to get him back away. Okay, we'll try and take the weight because I don't want to put too much weight on that hook because it might hurt him. Yep. Just get that right under him. Just watch his tail. Now I'll hug him in, I'll hug him in. I'll hug him into that shirt. Shirts are made for it, you see. Okay, there's no blood coming off that hook. I stayed away from the gills, which is good. Okay. Right, I don't want to muck around too long. Ow, spikes, spikes. Okay, now look at that guy. That's a beautiful breeding size fish. I mean, well, you saw how brazen he was living in around the kelp here. He's obviously a local boy. Now, just to keep these snapper breeding and this and the life cycle of these guys going, in the bay here, I'm gonna let this fella go. Just slide him nicely into the water and who knows? Seeing as we've been mates for the last half hour, he might just hang around for a bit more of a feed. He might even tell his mates, come over there and grab a feed. Look at that, away he goes. Now, of course, you guys can't be with me all the time because we can't have a camera with me 24/7. So what I'm gonna do, so we don't risk having a scenario again where we could miss some footage, is I'm gonna get a mat cam set up here. How's that? So hopefully you'll be getting a shot there of kind of what I'm seeing. And it looks like Justin might have one on now. So we'll test the system out. Well, there we go. I'm not sure if the lens on my camera is quite sensitive enough to pick up Justin's fish. But there you go.
Yeah.
And you get the raw emotion of Justin's face.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, that should give our viewers an appreciation of what I have to deal with. I think mainly due to the credit of our burley, we got to see some awesome action there. We've even caught enough fish for a feed, so we've got time now to go home, clean those up, but that's not where our day's going to end. In keeping with our theme of land-based fishing, we're going to be doing a different style of land-based fishing, and given all the walking we've been doing, the next stop is going to be a little bit more laid back. Well, the next bit of land-based fishing that we're going to do is going to be a little bit different than the land-based fishing that we've done before. For starters, we're going to be fishing off the sand. Now, normally when I'm fishing from shore, I'm looking for the rockiest, gnarliest bit of country I can find. But here, we've just got wide open flat sand. But that doesn't matter, because this thing here is going to be doing all the work. It's a seahorse, and it's going to be dragging out our 25 hooks. And all we've got to do is sit back and wait for the snapper and the fish to come in. This will probably do it. Yo, this will do it, bro. Go. Set the timer for 20 minutes, which should drag the line almost 2 kilometres out of the beach here. Then I'd simply start the motor, ignition. Justin, I'll get you to do the honours, mainly because I've got boots on and don't want to get wet. And as that goes out, we just clip our baits off. Well, now I guess we just sit and wait. Well, that's about long enough, I think. Time to wind the fish in.
It's a snapper.
Yep, this is the way to do it. If you bring a couple of mates along, you don't even have to unhook the line. Unhook the fish off as they come up. I tell you what, actually, in all seriousness, it's a very enjoyable, relaxing way to spend a few hours with some mates. And look at that, you get some fish with it. That's all right.
It's a beauty.
How's that, eh? That's not a bad one. That's a bloody good one. Snapper delivered to you.
Oh, there's a gurney.
Snapper.
A
gurney! You guys keep that snapper, boy.
Gurney! Woohoo!
Oh, snapper. I mean, anyone can catch a snapper, but... Oh, I mean, stunningly beautiful to look at and to eat. Amazing, the gurney. I mean, when we put this line out, all jokes aside, I said, couple of gurney and I'm happy. Those boys are excited about that big snapper. And rightly they should be. But this one here, it's coming home. It's coming home with me. What is it?
It's a puffer fish.
A puffer fish. Hey! We've got a beach ball. Holy smokes. Now, I have never seen one of these live before. Quite often you'll see them floating on the surface when they've been dragged up by a trawl net and discarded overboard, and they inflate and they can't get back down. And yeah. I've even seen them on the surface with marlin regurgitating them. The marlin will try and swallow them, they blow up inside the throat and they get jammed inside the throat of the predatory fish, and then the marlin will turn its stomach inside out, regurgitate everything just to get one of these out. I'm not sure what they eat, but you can see they've got this real bony plate like a parrotfish. And he's come along and he's taken one of our baits.
And these bikes, they're rigid. I mean, that is really quite taut. And those spikes are nasty. I wouldn't eat it. Look at that tiny little tail. I mean, it really can't have much propulsion. It's got an amazing eye, and it's found its way onto our line. Wow. So we'll just get him back out there so he can go away and do his thing. You wanna let that go? I'm gonna keep winching the line, and this is getting exciting. Woohoo! Another gurnard racing his way up the beach. Woohoo! Look at that. Justin's got his snapper. Just look at that. Oh, that's a nice snapper. In anyone's language, that's a nice snapper. But mate, I'll take these carrots. You have your snapper. That's probably all the time we've got for right here, at least for this spot right now.
Another gurnard.
Another gurnard! There you go! It just keeps getting better. But seriously, that's probably all we've got time for this week on the ITM Fishing Show. But tune in next week for your weekly fishing fix.
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode. But if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.